time to get paid, blow, time to get paid, time to get paid, blow up like I'm blowing up like you thought I would. I'm blowing up like you thought I would. And if you don't know, I'm blowing up like you thought I would.
How's it going, Falcons? Let's check out this week's show.
So stick by and enjoy the show.
My show has a new featured movie.
Hey Falcons, want a great book to read? Well, I got one for you.
Hey Falcons, come on over to our show to see what this week's topic is. Hey Falcons, this week's question is, how will you spend your spare time?
Let's learn the history of Spring Break on Weekly History.
Want to know which song fits this week's theme? Come to my show and find out.
Are you guys excited for spring break? Because I'm exhausted. But anyways,
I'm your host, Joshua Murillo.
And I'm your co-host, Bruno Jackson.
The word of the week is vacation.
It's me falling down the stairs.
Vacation, because for spring break, we will be going on vacation.
The number of the week is 5. Because we will have a 5-day vacation over spring break. Well, let's start the show off with weekly poll.
Hey Falcons, this week's theme is all about spring break. How will you spend your spring break? Enough talking, let's go check out what they have to say.
I'd honestly just play games and take naps every day.
I'm gonna go on vacation.
During the entirety of summer break, I'm gonna farm Brawl Stars.
I'm gonna play some Warzone.
I'm gonna eat. Play video games all day.
I'm gonna eat chips.
Oh, I'm gonna sleep during spring break.
Play sports.
Play my Nintendo Switch.
I'm going on vacation.
I'm gonna go on vacation for a week. Video games.
Spring break, I'm gonna just, you know, go to see some family in Guadalajara.
Oh, no. Oh my god, I will go to Nashville Farm.
I'm gonna sleep during.
My name is Jerome, and I was honestly going to college.
Here are your results.
Hey Falcons, this week's winner is video games with 44%. Sleep with 13%, vacation with 19%, eat with 13%, and play with 13%. Have a good day.
Hopefully you enjoy your vacation.
Hello. These crab creatures have a unique...
Hey guys, let me tell you a joke. How do celebrities stay cool?
Tell me, how?
They have many fans.
It's time for Game Alert, so let's hear it with our host, Jacob.
What's up, Falcons? I'm your host, Jacob Gonzalez. Welcome back. This week's theme is Spring Break. The game that we are going to show you this week is Kirby and the Forgotten Lands. In this game, Kirby explores a mysterious new world and gains abilities on the way. The reason we chose this game is because the release date takes place in spring break. Speaking of release dates, this game came out on March 25th, 2022. This game is only available on Nintendo Switch. Now before I get to the rating, I have some important news for you. We are selling pins and they're $2. Now that's a steal. According to Nintendo Life, this game's rating is a 9 out of 10. Now this is the perfect game to play during spring vacation.
Look at this scoundrel. Look at this little scallywag, this little devious guy. What is he doing? What is he doing?
This game will take most players 5. to 10 minutes to beat each level in this game. Enough of that, let's jump into the trailer. That's it for today, Falcons. Back to the studio.
Let's go check out at the movies and what they're showing.
Welcome, students. The featured movie we have for you is The Lorax. This movie is rated PG. This movie is about the Lorax trying to stop the trees from dying and keep natural air. This movie may be available on Apple TV and Vudu, and it was released on March 2nd, 2012. Before we watch the trailer, I must tell you something. We are currently selling Fatv pins for $2.
That's $2 cash.
So if you're interested, talk to some of us from Fatv. All right, now let's go watch the trailer.
Next year, from the creators of Despicable Me, wow.
Okay.
Who are you and what are you doing here? Get out of here and leave me alone!
People say that if someone brings you this stuff, that you'll tell them about trees.
You want to know about trees? About what happened to them? It all started a long time ago.
Can we start not so long ago, maybe?
It all started a long, long time ago.
Wow.
All right, here we go. About to change the world. Little did I know, I had just summoned a mystical creature as old as time itself. A legendary, slightly annoying, Lorax.
Hey! Whoa. Oh. Did you chop down this tree?
What's that?
Hey. I think he did it.
The Lorax.
I want to hear the end of the story.
Come back tomorrow. And don't let the boot hit you on the way out.
The boot?
Go! I have watched this movie about 5.
I told you! It's returned.
Hello, your computer has virus.
Time. We hope you enjoy your vacation. We will see you next time.
Let's hear it for our next show, Weekly History.
Welcome to my show, Weekly History. I'm your host, Angelina Martinez. This week's theme might be more appealing than last week's because as today, we're going to be learning the history of spring break. Well, let's start.
The concept of spring break began in 1938 with a swim event in Florida. By around 1960, however, the students had begun to come into town in great numbers. They suggested to have spring breaks so students can have a break. Though the tradition itself is relatively new, spring break is a common feature of college life for many American students, and some consider it to be one of the most highlights of the college experience. While many students use their week-long March vacations to relax and recharge, others use the opportunity to travel to exotic locations. Although spring break traditions sometimes vary from school to school and region to region, the experience itself has become a symbol of modern American college life. By 1985, more than 3,700 students were traveling to F. Lodore to enjoy their spring breaks also so they could have fun instead of studying. They are trying to see what's out there. Also, make sure to go buy our cool trendy buttons for only $2 and have a great fun spring break vacation.
Well, that's all for today, Falcons. We hope you have a great spring break, and we know we will.
Now for the weirdest part of the show, we have Weird Science up next.
Hey Falcons, today's essential question is how do living things reproduce?
How do living things reproduce?
But what does reproduce even mean?
That's why we're going to explain 6 different key terms.
To reproduce means to make more species. Asexual reproduction is a form of reproduction that only includes one parent.
Genetic material is the hereditary substance in the cell. It carries all information to an organism. It is also known as DNA.
An offspring is an organism that is the result of reproduction. Sexual reproduction is where plants and animals create offspring by combining genetic material. Budding. This is a type of asexual reproduction where a plant grows buds. Now that that's over, let's get to the essential question. How do living things reproduce?
Living things reproduce in different ways. One of their ways they reproduce is asexually. Asexual reproduction does not need fertilization, and this reproduction only requires one parent. This offspring inherits a full set of genes from that single parent. That's the way bacteria, archaea, many plants, fungi, and certain animals can reproduce.
In a plant's perspective, you can use budding.
The other type of reproduction is sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is a biological process by which plants and animals create offspring by comparing both of their genetic material. In this situation, both the sperm and the egg would be needed.
These are the different types of ways that living things reproduce.
Thank you for watching, Falcon. Don't forget to buy our FATV pin for $2.
$2.
Don't forget to have a great fight.
Watch this hydraulic press crush this Lego.
5-day vacation.
If you like to read books, then you're in luck because book club is up next.
The book I chose is Diary of a Wimpy Kid, The Deep End, and I chose this book because it talks about
Hey, don't eat corn! You can't misspelled it! Look at him! I'm 86!
Now I'm gonna read you a part in the story. August Thursday. I love my family and all, but I don't need to spend 24 hours a day with them, 7 days a week, and that's exactly the way it's been around here lately. It's not just me who's getting tired of this, either. We're all going a little nuts, and if things don't change soon, I think we're gonna go off the deep end. Mom says we've been cooped up for too long and we just need a vacation. But what we really need is a vacation from each other. That's not gonna happen anytime soon though, because we don't have any money. And the reason we don't is kind of a long story. We've been living in grandma's basement for 2 months and I don't know how much longer we can keep going like this. Mom says that one day we'll look back on this time and smile. But she's not the one who has to share a futon with Roderick every night. So this book is about how Greg Heffley goes on a vacation and gets stranded because things don't go too well.
Well, that's all for the book stockings. And if you guys want one of these cool looking pins, you can now buy them for $2.
$2.
And you should really buy 5 of them. Now back to the studio.
Let's end the show off with the song of the week. See you next week, Falcons.
What's up, Falcons? My name is Maciel Gonzalez and I'm your host for Song of the Week. This week's song is Passion Fruit by Drake. We chose this song because it reminds me of spring break and summer break, which are both vacations. This is probably my favorite song from the album. Before I end the show, I want to talk about the FATV pins we're selling. These pins cost $2 and you should definitely buy 5. Of them. Anyways, thanks for listening. Bye, Falcons.
Harder building trust from a distance. I think we should.